When I first met up with Wendy and Nick, Nick was pumping up the tire on his unicycle and Wendy was doing some stretches. I took this opportunity to ask them, you know, where can we actually shoot you on a unicycle? I had the great idea of photographing them on a unicycle in the grass in front of the tent, but in our conversation, it turns out unicyclists don't like to ride their unicycle in the grass. They like to be on a hard surface, preferably concrete. So while they were prepping for the shoot, stretching and pumping up the tire, I went outside and found a new location. I lucked out because there was a basketball court directly across from the tent. It wasn't the ideal situation because it had a chain link fence around it, but instead of getting frustrated with that, I just embraced that as an element to our location. Cool, let's start with the unicycle and we'll start outside and then we'll move our way in.
Great.
Let me just grab my cameras. Once Nick and Wendy were ready to start taking some pictures, we left the tent and walked over to the basketball court. I'd never photographed unicycling before, so I was just real honest and asked them, what are you gonna do and where do I need to stand, basically? All right, so since I have no idea what you guys actually do, I'm gonna let you just kind of do it and I'm gonna step back and sort of shoot. And then as I sort of learn.
We go in circles?
Okay.
So there's a couple of things we can do.
Okay.
They
said they could do some sort of poses where he'd actually be on the unicycle and she would be on his shoulders or sometimes even on his head.
Okay.
And then they would also do some performing for me, which meant that they would go around in a circle doing their activities.
Okay.
I decided to keep it simple for the beginning. Don't do anything with motion, but just sort of do the more static poses.
Wow.
Wow, I love my job. Did not expect this today.
Ready? Yeah.
Once we got the more simple stationary images of Nick and Wendy on the unicycle, they wanted to do some more complicated tricks for me. But before they did that, they wanted to practice them. And when they practiced them, they didn't do it on the unicycle. They just did it on the ground. And I just was taking pictures the whole time. And I'm glad I was, because what I realized was them just on the ground and not on the unicycle was really beautiful. And then by placing the unicycle in the foreground of my image, I have all the data that I want. I have all the storytelling elements that I wanted in one frame. I've got the unicycle, I've got them being performers, and I had the tent in the backdrop. And so initially I would have thought them doing these crazy cool things on the unicycle would be the image, but in reality, the image was them preparing to do it. So again, it's like just be in the moment and accept what's really happening around you and realizing, oh, that's the image. And then just keep working it until you dial it in. Don't look at me as a general rule.
Okay.
How are your shoulders doing?
You can stay here forever.
Are you serious? I got some wide shots with the tent in the background and I had to sort of direct them at one point and say, hey, you know, you guys can stand wherever you want, but for me, the best spot is right here. So I had the backdrop that I wanted and they were very accommodating and did that. I got some shots and one thing that I liked was when I walked in on Nick and I had to remind myself, you know, this is a portrait project I'm trying to do. I'm not doing one of my usual reportages. And so I walked in and made a portrait of Nick. It's one of my favorite pictures because it's Nick in a nice formal kind of portrait composition, but then he's got these feet standing right here. And then there's another one with the feet standing on his head. And he's got this great mustache. And so I think it's a picture that's got a lot of character and it tells a story because by itself, his face would be awesome. But with some feet standing right here, that's a whole narrative. Cool. One thing I noticed right off the bat with these guys was they were athletic. These guys were athletes and it wasn't easy. I actually got kind of nervous when Wendy would get on top of Nick's head. And I know they're professionals, I know they know what they're doing, but as me as a photographer asking them to do things a little bit longer than they may naturally do, I stepped in and I say, you know, once I got my picture, guys, if you need to relax or come down off his shoulders for a minute, then do it. And I think that really made the relationship work better for the rest of the photo shoot because they knew that they were in a safe place. They didn't have to exert themselves beyond what they needed to just for me. Because you know what? If they're happy and feeling relaxed in front of the camera, we're going to have better pictures.
So that's those skills.
Okay.
We have a few if you want to try to get some of the...
Let's try it. Get something with a little motion in it, see what happens.
Yeah.
And then we'll do some pose stuff that will be a lot easier for you.
Great.
Cool. since unicycling by its very nature has a lot of movement in it, I was kind of excited about actually having them go around me in a circle and then me trying to track Nick and get a little blur in the background. That's what, yeah, that's kind of what I wanted to do, is kind of do one of these.
Yeah, so let me go ahead and set my circle.
Okay. I tried it for about 5 to 10 minutes and it just wasn't working. It's so bright out here today. I was shooting at F22 and at what's called a low 2 setting on my ISO on the Nikon. So it's the lowest possible ISO setting I can have. And I couldn't get my shutter speed low enough to get the blur. I think I was shooting it at 1/25 of a second. So it just wasn't working. In the ideal world, I would have had what's called some ND filters or neutral density filters in my kit that I could put on there and cut down some of the exposure, but I didn't have that today. Not the end of the world, but the important thing is very quickly I realized this isn't working for me, and I stopped, and I stopped them so they didn't get exhausted, and we moved on to the next thing I wanted to do, which is doing some portraits outside of the basketball court. Okay, so what I want to do is do it with me just standing right here. And then, I don't know if you want to do it twice, what I want to do is also do it on the other side of the fence where I'm shooting through.
Okay.
So I don't know if you want to get down and then get back up, or if you just want to hold it.
We'll come down and get back.
Okay, cool. So at one point, I actually stepped outside the basketball court and shot through the chain link fence and just incorporated that as an element. You know, if you're just looking at it, it looks all the same, but with something like that in the foreground, if you get low, it looks very different than when you're high. And the closer you get to the chain link fence is very different than far back, because you're actually adding a whole layer of texture in front of your subject matter. So whenever you're doing that, whether it's grass in the foreground or a chain link fence, it's good to play around, get lots of different angles, move up and down, try it all. You're only gonna be here once.
Well, that's fine. Great.
Is there anything else in here you wanna do? Like action stuff? Anything with the unicycle?
I think that's good.
Yeah. You good? Okay. Once I felt confident that I had enough images inside the basketball court and enough images with a little bit of movement with the unicycle, I decided it's time to move on. We're on a schedule. And I headed out of the basketball court and back towards the tent to take some formal portraits.